Hi viewers, once again we are here. We are here to present you another spoiler on Jordan Akbar. Like we always do, we are here to look at another spoiler or an upcoming twist on Jordan Akbar. But before we start, look on your screen, you will see something like this. Click on it, subscribe to the channel so that our next spoilers, you will be the first person to get them and then what? Watch them. Now that you are done subscribing, let's look at what we came here to do. So today we are here to look at how Jordan got pregnant and gave one of her children to Rukia, and how Rukia tried to use that against Jala and Jordan to be able to separate them, and then how Maham's curse got what fulfilled, because when Maham was about to die, she cursed Jordan that when Jordan gives birth, there's no way she will be able to see her children. The moment Maham, the last moment Maham died, she took back her curse. But yes, so that curse came to pass, and then Jordan gave birth and then lost all her twins. She was very broken. You can imagine when you give birth to twins and then you lose them all. The twins are all female. The twin Jordan gave birth to are all female, no male. But Jala was very happy, and initially Jala didn't want to agree to the decision that Jordan will give birth and give one to Rukia. But let's see what happens. So let's start. So Hamida tells Salima that Rukia's demand is completely legitimate and inhuman. She supports Jala's decision. Salima thinks Rukia's mental condition is really critical. So Hamida is against Rukia's decision that she wants one of Jordan's children when she gives birth. But as you all know, this is also part of Rukia's what plan to be able to separate Jala and Jordan. So let's continue. Jordan also agrees with her. Rukia celebrates the success of the first step of her game. She says that now she's using Jordan's emotion and humanity for her own political success. Her emotional drama must have touched Jordan, and she will act accordingly, thinks Rukia. Jala comes to meet Rukia. She pretends being a distressed woman, deprived of pleasure of being a mother. He tries to comfort her. She says that she understands his problem and will not make the demand again. Jordan comes in front of the sacred scale of justice to solve her confusion. She thinks Rukia's demand can be fulfilled. She tells Jala that it will be inhuman to deprive Rukia from the pleasure of being a mother when she is being blessed with two children. Jala argues that a child can be raised only by its own mother, but still Jordan insists. Jala disapproves Jordan's decision to give away one of their child. Jordan feels it is justified to give one to what? Rukia. How will you give birth and give one to another person to look at? Whilst your husband doesn't want to agree, yes, still you want to go on and do that. Okay. So she tells Jala that it will be, sorry. Jordan decides to give Rukia one of her child so she too can have a child. Happy, Jordan decides to give away a child to Rukia. After getting one child from Jordan, Rukia will harm Jordan, so her child will be in danger and Jala will be angry on her. Jala is very excited for their twins, and if one of the child will be in danger due to Jordan, then Jala will automatically leave Jordan, because Jala was very happy that now they've given birth, and now if per Jordan's recklessness or insecurity, she's going to leave or he's going to lose one of the children, then definitely she will be away from what, Jordan. But all this are plans of what, Rukia, so that she can separate Jala from what, Jordan. So Rukia will separate Jordan and Jala and become Maram Uz Zamani, which what, mother, like Jala was to what, Maham. The relationship between Maham and Jordan, that's the same relationship Rukia is trying to build between her and then Jordan's children. But Jordan will get to know about Rukia's evil plan. Let's see what she will do. When Jordan and Jala start discussing their girls' name, Razia and Radha, Rukia will inquire about it. She will get angry by knowing both are girls, and names will start overreacting. As she would become Maryam Uz Zamani, she doesn't want a girl child. So per Rukia's intention, she wants what, a male child, so that she can use that person, and that person will in the future become what, the king. That's why she wanted what, a male child. She also said that only she will decide the second child's name, as it will be hers only. This will surely leave Jada shocked, and Jada will start thinking about her decision that it's a very big mistake. It's a very big mistake. It's a very big mistake. How can you give birth and give one to another person to take off? Will you do the same thing if it was you? Will you do the same thing if it were to be you? Let's see your comment. So Jala meets Kasim and his wife Zinat. Rukia bestows Zinat with the responsibility of being Hazin's nanny. Later, it turns out that Kasim and Zinat came to destroy Jala. So when is Jala going to stop making enemies? Everyday enemies, everyday enemies. And these same people killed their twins. They came there, killed the twins, Jordan's children. How can you involve Jordan in Jala's affairs? Okay. So after Hazan's death, Jada was completely broken, but Jala tried to console her. Rukia was also alert for Hazan and she Huzan, and she didn't touch anyone except Zinat, as she's the caretaker of what, Huzan. So they named the children Hazan and then what, Huzin. So Jada was taking care of Hazan and then Rooks was taking care of Huzin. So Jala can't see Jordan's condition, so he tried to console Rukia that Jordan has right to spend time with Huzan. In this fight, Rukia's head got worse, then Jala gave Huzan towards Jordan. Jordan is so conscious with Huzan after losing Hazan. Zinat is trying to find right time to kill Huzan, and she got it when Jala was hurt. Zinat forced Jordan to be with Jala, then Jordan went towards Jala and Zinat will kill Huzan. At last, Maham's curse is fulfilled and Jordan's twins died. Jordan and Jala will again be broken due to the kid's death. Rukia won't be upset of losing Huzan, but she will feel that she lost the chance to become Maram Uzamani. Zinat and Kasim will also reveal their evil deeds, that they kill Hazan and Huzan. What do you think will be their punishment for this evil deed? But Jala will also change and become the earlier Jala who doesn't have any heart. So after this incident, Jala is going to change and become that what, heartless person again. No mercy for the cripple. What do you think about this? If it were to be you, what will you do? How will you punish these people? Killing your children, your happiness, how will you punish them? So this is where we'll end today's spoiler. Try and subscribe to our channel because there are more spoilers coming. Don't miss out. Subscribe to the channel so that the new ones will be posting on this same channel. You'll be the first person to watch them. Like I said, don't go without subscribing. Subscribe because there are more spoilers coming on Jordan Agba and other series. So subscribe to our channel for more spoilers, updates and teasers. See you soon. Bye bye.